And yeah, they've been staying with me for 3 weeks here in America, and I lived in Germany with them for a while, and that's how I get to meet them. So, couple questions here. Pretty easy, pretty basic. Most of them I know already, but we want them in your own words.
Hello, right? I'm Dennis from Social Distortion. I'm here with the bass player, John.
Hey, how are you? My name's John Maurer. Yes, my friends call me Johnny.
Okay, and how long you guys been together now?
10 years.
10 years. And in your eyes, have you seen a great change in the scene?
Yeah.
So
I think it's coming full circle. Oh yeah, I think it's definitely wasn't supposed to stay the same, but I think nowadays people in the punk scene are tending to be very, very, you know, ordinary, and they're not doing, you know, nothing shocking anymore. Whatever they can do, I think people are falling into the same rut that the whole punk scene was trying to get out of.
More trendy than anything.
Well, yeah, it's just more of a fuck, you know. I mean, you go to the malls nowadays, and they sell black leather jackets and, you know, jeans and black shoes and shit, you know. And it's like Janet Jackson's wearing the shit, and Michael Jackson's wearing bondage gear, you know. So it's just lost its whole shock value.
And is Mike around?
He's not around right now, but let me say one thing. We're not really into the, you know, the whole clothes or fashion thing. We're more into it for the music.
That's it. I understand you. As you can see, we're pretty same. Yeah, and in your audience, you definitely see a difference. You know, I mean, here with the total aggression and everything.
Well,
I mean,
it'll happen anywhere, but
well, it's getting better.
We don't
every
condone
time,
the
man.
Violence, you know. I mean, it is getting better. I don't think there was any fights tonight or anything like that. We're just here to, you know, entertain people and have people have a good time.
Here's a good one for you. How did you get hooked up with Neil Young and Crazy Horse?
Shit, Neil called us on the phone and said, "Hey, man, I like your music and I want you guys to open for us." I guess his son. His son's a big fan of ours, and Neil asked his son, who I've never met, what band should he bring on tour with him in the States, and he said Social Distortion. So that's how it came about.
That ain't bad. I like that one. Okay, favorite brands, favorite idols,
favorite bands? Gosh, anybody from X to Hank Williams to the Ramones, you know? Anything from very contemporary to very, you know, obscure 50s rockabilly.
Cool, all right.
You know, we like a lot of black minority blues groups and things like that.
Well, that was the beginning. That was the roots to begin with, anyway, right?
Muddy Waters.
But okay, here's what. How you standing on a drug and alcohol scene?
I don't. You know,
you're standing on it.
That's good for people, but you know, it's whatever people want to do. I don't, you know.
Hey, you don't want to be.
I don't shoot up heroin and shit like that, you know. But I am. You know, there's a big problem with drugs and things in America, with crack and that sort of thing, and it's really too bad that people don't have enough self-control or enough, you know, they're not strong-minded enough to realize, you know, what kind of lifestyle or what that will bring you.
All right,
you know, I mean, if people can party and take care of it, that's fine, obviously there's people who can't.
And how's this, what do you see in your future, your next plans?
Next plans is to go back to Los Angeles, you know, do some surfing, start recording a new album, and then, you know, just be touring all summer as well.
Tour the States as a new major band.
Maybe
yes.
We'll get over to over to Europe this summer.
Yeah, that's the next. What do you think about Europe?
We'd like to go, you know, Germany or you know, up even to Amsterdam or something like that. We want to go to Japan and Australia as well. So,
yeah.
You know, all these things are. You know, we got to finish up this tour first before we worry about that.
Right. And how old are you again?
How old am I? Shit, I'm in my late 20s.
Late 20s. No exact you're going to give me.
Shit, I don't know, man. I was an orphan when I was born, so I don't really know my exact birthday.
All right.
That's more rock and roll.
Okay, what do you think about this fucked war that's going on at the present moment?
Hey, we want peace, you know? We need peace.
That's it.
That's the bottom line, and that's all I got to say
about it.
Need peace.
Okay, here's a good one. Here is something I read in a magazine, or in a newspaper actually. It stated that that Mike actually didn't own any of the original Social Distortion records.
Yeah. Mike doesn't own them? Shit, he doesn't buy his own records. Why would he?
No, I mean from the original prints or none. He has nothing like that. That means nothing to him. Or
yeah, he collects other things, you know. I'm sure he wishes he had them. I have a lot of original old records. And things,
I got some original Posh Boy myself.
But, you know, it's like those are in limited pressing and, you know, what can you say? People are selling it for a lot of money.
Yeah,
so
$200,
like,
$200, man. I paid $5 for it years ago.
Well, shit, price and everything goes up.
Yeah, okay, any closing, anything you want to say? That's about all I got written down.
I would just like to, you know,
Dennis.
Say hello to everybody in Germany. I just want to say peace, brother. Peace.
Peace. Hey,
that's all I want to say.
Thanks for your time, man.
Thanks.
You ripped it up. Great show. Take care of yourself, all right?
All right. Cool.
And have fun with the rest of your tour, all right? Take care, guys.